Hello guys, my name is Ashish and welcome to the Angular tutorial series for beginners. In the previous lecture we have discussed how to create a component in Angular based project. In today's lecture we are going to discuss about the data binding and the property binding in Angular. So guys, before starting the lecture I request you all to subscribe the xAdmin channel to get notification whenever a new lecture is uploaded. And guys, please hit the like button at the end if you like it, so that it will encourage me to bring more awesome lectures for you guys. So guys, let's start. What is the property binding in Angular framework? So guys, firstly I will explain the data binding. So guys, data binding means the communication between the TypeScript code of your component and your template, which is the user C. So guys, here the template is the HTML file, right? So guys, data binding means the communication between the TypeScript code of your component and your template, which is the user C, right? So guys, data binding is available right from Angular JS and all the version of the Angular release later on. Data binding is one of the most powerful and the important features in any software development language. So guys, data binding is one of the most powerful and the important features in any software development language. It allows us to define communication between the component and the view. So guys, with the help of the data binding we can do the communication between the component and the view. So we can say that data binding is passed from component to view and from view to the component, right? So guys, next, the data binding can be either one way or two way. Angular provides various type of data binding like string interpolation. Second is the property binding. Third is the event binding, and the fourth is the two-way bindings. Okay guys, so guys, string interpolation, property binding, event binding, and the two-way binding. So next, what is string interpolation? It is the type of one-way binding where the text is in between the set of a curly braces, often use the name of the component property. Angular replaces that name with the string value of the corresponding component property. The syntax of the string interpolation is to use double curly braces. Okay guys, so guys, in the previous lecture we have discussed about the string interpolation. So guys, next is what is the property binding? Property binding allows us to bind the view of the template expression. Property binding is a simple term, is defined as updating the value of a certain variable in component and displaying it in its view. So guys, property binding is also a one-way data binding, where we bind a property of a DOM element to a field, which is the property we define in our component TS code, right? Thus, it allows you to change the value wherever you want, but only at the component level. We can change the value, but only at the component level we can change. So guys, behind the scene, Angular converts string interpolation into the property binding. So guys, the most important point to note is that the string interpolation and the property binding both are one-way binding. Okay guys, so guys, the string interpolation and the property binding both are one-way binding. That means if the field value in the component changes, then the Angular will automatically update the DOM, but any changes in the DOM will not reflect it back to the components. Okay guys, So guys, string interpolation and the property binding both are one-way binding. Okay, so next we are going to see how to implement the property binding in our Angular-based project. So guys, this is a small Angular project. Okay, guys. So guys, this is a string interpolation. We are using the string interpolation here. Okay, inside the double curly braces we have written D. So guys, now we are going to see the output of this. So guys, this is the output where we are getting like A, B, C. Okay guys, so this is the use of the interpolation. So guys, inside like data is an array in which like data inside A, B, C object has been present. So guys, we are iterating the object of the array, and we are displaying all the object of the array with the use of the interpolation, right guys? So guys, next we are going to see how to implement the property binding in this. So guys, for that I'm going to take an input field, and input, and which type will be of text type. Okay, this is of text type, and the value I'm going to put is like xadmin, right guys? So guys, this is an input tag in which type is of text type, and the value is xadmin. So guys, now I'm going to compile the file, and we are going to see the output of this. So guys, you can see that a text box has been created with a value xadmin. Okay guys, so guys, now I have to use the property binding in this. So guys, for property binding, the value from the TypeScript will display to our view. So guys, now let create one variable inside, in which I'm keeping the name as property, in which I am assigning as property string, right? Okay guys, so next what we have to do, we have to display the property. So guys, I'm going to do the property binding. Okay, so guys, next what we have to do, we will display the value in our HTML. So for that, we have to write this property inside our HTML, inside our app component.html, like here. Okay guys, like here. But guys, for the property binding, we have to keep the value in the inside the square bracket. So inside the square bracket, we have to keep the value inside the square bracket. So guys, this is the property binding. So guys, now we can see the output in this. So guys, we get the output as the property binding inside the text box. So guys, in this, what is happening? Happening, the value of the property is showing in the HTML. So guys, we are taking the value of the property variable, and we are showing it to the HTML file. So guys, we have to keep in mind that we have to keep the value inside a square bracket. Then only it is a guys, it is a one-way binding. We are sending the data from the component file to our template. So guys, this is our template. So guys, we are sending the data from the TS file to our HTML file. Okay. So guys, next what we are going to see do. So guys, next the simply I am going to write a div. Inside div, I am going to write a simple string like welcome to xadmin channel, right? So guys, after compiling, we can see the output as welcome to xadmin channel. So guys, now I am going to hide this div. So guys, we can use div hidden. Okay guys, so guys, by default the hidden value is true. So guys, we can see the output as, now guys, welcome to the xadmin channel has been hidden here, right? So guys, welcome to xadmin channel has been hidden. So guys, next what we can do, we can use the property binding here and we can change according to our need. So so guys, for that put the hidden inside a square bracket, right? And after this take one variable with the is hidden and assign this is hidden inside the TS file. So guys, here the is hidden is of the boolean type. So boolean type, okay, and I am assigning the value as false. Okay guys, so hidden value is false here. So guys, hidden value is false. So guys, hidden is false. So guys, we can see that welcome to xadmin has been displayed. So guys, in the same way, if we do the is hidden as true, if I change the is hidden value with a true, then guys, we can see that here the hidden is true. Okay, so hidden is true means the welcome to xadmin will get vanish. Okay guys, so guys, in the same way, we are using the property binding here. Okay, so guys, in the next what we are going to do, we are going to create a simple button, right? So check property binding, okay guys. So guys, we can compile and we can see in the HTML that guys this is a simple check property binding button, right? So guys, next what we can do, we can disable the button by using disabled, right? So so guys, as the disabled default value is always true, so guys, we can see that now the button will get disabled, right? See guys, you can see. So guys, now we can use the property binding and we can change the value of the disable also. So guys, for that you have to put the disable inside a square bracket, and again you can take one variable like is disable, right? Spelling is wrong. Disable is disable, and guys, we can initialize the is disable inside a TS file. So guys, we can see the default value of the is disable will be false. Okay guys, so guys, this is a boolean type, I think spelling mistake. Yes, this is of boolean type. So guys, we can see that now the is disable is false. So guys, we can click the button. See guys, we can change the value of this, right? So guys, in the same way, we can do the is disable as true. True, right? And guys, we can check the output. And the output is like, guys, here we can see the disable is true here, right? So guys, for the property binding, what we have to do, we have to put the element value inside a square bracket and then we can use the variable value, like the is hidden is true, then it will get hidden. Okay, so guys, like this we can use the property binding in our angular web-based project. So guys, property binding allows us to bind the view of the template expression, and the property binding is the simple term is defined as updating the value to a certain variable in a component and displaying it in a view. So guys, it is a one-way binding. we are sending the data from the TS file to our HTML file. So guys, this is a TS file. We are sending the data to from the TS to the HTML file. Okay guys, so guys, I hope you like this video on the property binding in Angular. Okay guys, thank you and have a nice day.